Hello, everyone. For this week's pet tip, we're talking to Dr. Jenna Hunter at Main Street Veterinary Clinic. Doctor, are there vitamins out there for our dogs and cats? And should we be giving them that?
Right, absolutely. There's all types of vitamins that are out there. Just like when you and I go to the health food aisle and we see vitamin E, vitamin A, you name it. We have a similar thing with animals. Now, granted, do they need usually a multivitamin type thing? On most of the good high-quality diets that are out there right now, if the animal's on it, it's very rare that you need to add a multivitamin supplement.
Okay.
The main animals that would benefit from that, maybe one's undergoing certain type of surgical procedures, you know, or if they're real finicky and we're having to feed them some of those things we've talked about before about not feeding them, that they may not be developing their own vitamins, so we recommend those. But you had asked me before, too, about, hey, when they get older, what else is there? And that's where the extras come in. We actually give glucosamine chondroitin vitamin supplements to dogs and cats for their achy bones and joints. That can be of benefit. We also have skin and coat vitamins that contain, like, the fish oils and type things. That, again, all these things that you and I see on the vitamin shelf for ourselves, there are some for animals, and some require them, you know, differently than others. And a lot of it's depending on what's going on, what situation they are in their life stage.
Okay, so that's the thing. How do you just look at your dog and think, I should start them on this right away? Probably not, right? It's kind of depends on the animal.
Absolutely. Now, it's never a bad idea if you want to give them a treat, like a multivitamin. That's fine. Go ahead and give one. I can't think of many reasons, unless it upsets their stomach, not to do that if you just want to give something. You know, however, if you start thinking about, should I give them a joint supplement? Should I give them a coat supplement? Do I give them something here it says for helping the immune system? Well, talk with your veterinarian about it. You know, I generally look at the skin coat supplements on those dry dogs that are shedding too much and you can just pull their hair out like little bristles. The older dogs who are a little hitching their get up, those are the joint supplement dogs.
Okay.
So no, I don't always say just give them all, because again, we want to give them the right amount, the right kind, and knowing that if we're giving something, am I doing good by it or not?
And are you going to get those from your veterinarian? Where would you actually get those different items?
It depends. We do have some that are specific animal related.
Okay.
There are some that, just like with people, that cost more than others. Mm-hmm. And the main reason being is usually the ones that cost more, they've gone through some testing, so we know that they work.
Okay.
Does that mean you can't pick up something over the counter? Well, of course you could if there's a similar product. You just may be giving more than what you would be of a different product. So that's why it's good to talk with your veterinarian about a supplement. How much do I give? What do I expect? How do I know if it's working or not?
Okay, great. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Dr. Hunter. We appreciate that. And now we'll go visit Lumberton Animal Control. All right, everyone, meet Susie. Now, this she's probably about full grown. We think she's a little less than 2 years old. She's probably about close to a year and a half and looking like she's full grown. And I will tell you, this is one of the calmest dogs. See, look right there. She's just hanging out. Susie, you want to go to a good home, don't you? Look in the camera and tell the camera that. Look at, yeah, there she goes, little wag of the tail. Okay, obviously some sort of mixed breed, but we have to tell you, this is definitely one of the calmest dogs we've seen here. Very mild mannered, and of course about under 2 years old, so should be going to a really great family home. She's at Lumberton Animal Control. All you have to do is call the Lumberton Police Department. They will connect you to Animal Control, and come get Susie and give her a good home. For this week's Save a Pet, I'm Jessica Gittry.